Hi everyone! Welcome to our coding interview questions. In today's video, I will show you how to find all substrings within a given string that are palindromes. As a single character is, in fact, a palindrome, I will extract only palindromes with length greater than 1. And for sake of simplification, I'm not validating the input. If you don't know much about palindromes, I recommend you watch first our video about how to check if a string is a palindrome. The link should be staring you right now, but I also put it in the description below. Now, let's learn together a bit more about palindromes and string manipulation. We'll work with two different approaches for finding palindromes in a string. The first one is using brute force. We will extract all possible substrings with two or more characters and check if they are palindromes. Before coding, let's follow this algorithm using an animation. We are using the index start and the index end. As we don't want to check single characters, we have the index start initially assigned to 0 and the index end to 1. We then extract the substring from the position start to end, including the character indexed by the index end. So, here we have AB. The last step is to check if the substring is a palindrome. As AB is not the case, we can advance the index end. Now, the substring is ABA, which is a palindrome. Therefore, we need to add it to the output. We follow the same logic until the index end has the same value of the input string length, minus 1, in this case 4, because the string is 0 indexed. Now, we can start again, advancing starting 1 and assigning the index end to the value of the index start plus 1. This way, the index end will be always ahead of the index start. It is the same logic we have been using. When the index start is equal to the input string length minus 2, we can stop. The next comparison would be the last character with the next, which doesn't make sense. Again, keep in mind that we want only substrings with two or more characters. Now, let's code this. If you followed the previous animation, I believe you already have an idea of what to do. We need two nested for loops. So, for each value of the index start, we can make the index end go from start plus 1 until the end of the input string. As we don't need to compare the last character, the start loop ends when the index reaches the input string length minus 1. Then we just need to extract the substring and check if it is a palindrome. I'm using end plus 1 here because in JavaScript, the second argument of the substring function represents the first character to be excluded from the returned substring. Note that I'm using the setThat structure instead of an array to store the result. The reason for that is we want to avoid repetitions. However, it's important to pay attention on the question description. It can have small variations about what we are doing here. And that's it. We can test our function now. For that, I'm using some test cases I have already prepared. Each test case has the input string and an array with all expected palindromes. As expected outputs are declared as arrays, I'm using array from to convert a set in an array. And I'm sorting the result just for testing, since deep strict equal compares the object values expecting the same order. Let's run our program. As we haven't got any errors, we are all good. Just to be sure, let's change one of the expected values and run the program again. Yes, the program has thrown an error informing a difference between the actual value and the expected one. Now let's fix this and run again the tests. In code interviews, it's common to ask about complexity. Complexity is the amount of resources required to run an algorithm or a program. Usually, these resources vary according to the size of the input. The most common resources are time and memory space. Time complexity is the amount of time to run the algorithm, considering the size of the input. For that, we don't use the usual units of time as milliseconds, because this would depend on many factors as hardware configuration and operating systems. Instead, we estimated time by counting the number of elementary operations performed by the algorithm. Space complexity is the amount of memory space required by the solution, also considering the size of the input. The complexity is generally expressed using big O notation, which always considers the worst-case scenario. For the brute force solution, the time complexity is big O of n powered by 3. This is because we have 3 nested loops. Each one will basically loop all the string length. The first 2 are to control the values of the index start and the index end. And the last one is to check if the substring is a palindrome. I'm considering here that the solution used for checking palindromes has a time complex of big O of n. The space complexity of this solution is constant, hence big O of 1. Just to clarify, input and output shouldn't be considered when calculating algorithm space complexity. The space complexity of an algorithm is the amount of extra space it uses. Now, we can move to our second approach. In this new solution, each character of the input string is used as a pivot acting as the center of the possible palindromes. Then, we expand in both directions to continue check for palindromes. We need to check for palindromes of odd and even lengths. Note that if the left index is less than 0, or the right index is equal to the input string length, or the left character is different from the right one, we can stop and advance for the next pivot. If the left character is equal to the right one, we found a palindrome and need to add it to the output. Then we expand one character to the left and one to the right, and check again. Here, only the check for palindromes of even length will continue. But as the next value for the left index is minus 1, we can stop and advance in the pivot. Now, our search for palindromes of odd length can stop. But we found a palindrome of even length, so we can expand. Again, we found another palindrome of even length, and then advance to the left and to the right. Now, the right character is equal to the input string length. As JavaScript uses zero index in strings, we can stop and advance the pivot. Here, we haven't found palindromes in both cases, so we could advance to the next pivot. However, we can stop because we want only palindromes with length greater than 1. Let's see how to implement this. In the main for loop, we check for odd and even palindromes, considering each character of the input string as a pivot. But we don't need to check the last character. The starting point to find odd characters is the immediate left and right characters of the pivot. This way, we are initially checking for a palindrome of length 3. If we find one, we expand the index and check for a palindrome of length 5, and so on. For palindromes of even length, the starting point is the pivot itself as the left index and the immediate character to the right. Now we start looking for a palindrome of length 2. If we find one, we expand the index and check for a palindrome of length 4, and so on. The support function checks the stop conditions, and while the left and right characters are identical, we need to add the substring as a palindrome and expand. The same way we did in the brute force solution, we are using the setDate structure to avoid repetitions. Let's now test this using the same set of test cases we have used in our previous solution. Yes, all tests have passed. The space complexity is still constant, hence big O of 1. However, the time complex has improved. Now we have big O of n powered by 2, as we have only 2 loops nested. And that's it for today. We have learned how to find all palindromes in a string using 2 different approaches. If you have any questions or suggestions, please leave your comments below. With this series, I intend to explore common code interview questions with different difficulty levels. So stay tuned for more. Thanks for watching, and I see you in the next video.